I'll try to say something about his one is Bhakti Charu Maharaj. Maharaj personifies sweetness. He would purchase devotees by his sweetness. Each and every gesture was filled with sweetness. And that's why we see that all the photographs also of Maharaj is like he's meeting someone, he's shaking hand or patting someone. He connects with devotees, not just verbally, but also physically as well. He would personally meet with devotees. So his super sweet nature. And the super exalted nature of his is also known by that what is the first book which he read? Nectar of Devotion. When we read Bhakti Shastri, when we study Bhakti Shastri, we study only 19 chapters, not 51 chapters. हम जाते ही नहीं है ईस्टर्न वे, उसके बाद सदर्न वे, वेस्टर्न वे, नॉर्दर्न वे, हम कभी खोलते ही नहीं है नेक्टर डिवोशन. बट महाराज ही रेड ऑल द वेव्स, सो ईस्टर्न वेव, सदर्न वे, वेस्टर्न वे, नॉर्दर्न वे, एंड ही अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग बिकॉज ही रेलिश्ड दैट बुक लाइक एनीथिंग. ही रेलिश्ड इट. सो दैट शोज द एग्जॉल्टेड नेचर ऑफ महाराज डिवोशन सर्विस राइट फ्रॉम वेरी बिगनिंग. एंड ही इज सर्टनली एन एसोसिएट ऑफ श्रील प्रभुपाद. Just in short span of 1 year, 1976, he gets connected and then he serves Srila Prabhupada in his final pastimes. Wow! In fact, he received Harinam initiation, Gayatri initiation, Sannyas initiation, one after the other. So, some devotees doubted. And Srila Prabhupada, you know, you are giving initiation so fast to this person, Bhakti Charu. What if he falls down? Srila Prabhupada said, well, he will not fall down. Even if he falls down, at the max, he can fall down to mode of goodness. That means he was transcendental, he is transcendental, and he will continue to remain transcendental. One more very beautiful quality of Maharaj is Vaishnav songs. In case we want to learn how to sing Vaishnav song, we straight away go to the folder of Bhakti Charu Maharaj ji. And then listen to that song. That this is the way we should sing Vaishnav song. Which with such sweetness, with such devotion. He is so pakka. He really sings them from his heart. So in terms of singing Vaishnav songs, he's awesome. He was awesome. And then in terms of presenting Siddhanta, very articulate. He would present Siddhanta so completely and in such a clear fashion that even most dumb person can understand Siddhanta coming from his glorious mouth. Especially, I like his series on Brihat Bhagavatamrita and Vaishnava etiquette. Maharaj was really amazing and he himself personified Vaishnava etiquette. We see so many Srila Prabhupada's disciples coming to honor this occasion. Why? Because they all are hypnotized by the love and affection which His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj, Guru Maharaj would give to everyone. Devotees told me that to invite any devotee for this program, he would go to that particular Vaishnava, Srila Prabhupada's disciple, have lunch prasadam with them and then invite them. So much of personalism in inviting someone for this festival. And just see what an attitude that on this festival, on my birthday, we'll glorify Srila Prabhupada. Not my birthday celebration, Srila Prabhupada's glorification, that's it. In fact, devotees told me that usually on his Vyas Puja celebrations, when the devotees would bring garlands, he would take the garland, stand next to Srila Prabhupada, would offer all the garlands to Srila Prabhupada, one after another. Amazing! What an attitude, what love, what a disciple. Actually, one of the reasons why Srila Prabhupada was so successful, because he had such glorious disciples. If he would have got disciples of modern age, then ISKCON would have stopped long time back. But we see such selfless devotion. My God, he is coming from very good background, very learned, very scholarly. And then he had natural inclination for devotional service. So his humbleness, his sweetness, his smile, $1 million smile. He can make devotee not by giving DYS, JSD, Journey of Self-Discovery or Discover Yourself. $1 million smile, devotee. That's it. So why his smile, he can make somebody a devotee. Sweet gestures. If anybody pays obeisances, he in return, he would pay obeisances. And in case his stomach is full, in case a devotee has brought prasadam, just to honor that love, he would take prasadam even though his stomach is full. So in terms of loving reciprocation, he was a champion. He was a Maharathi, he was a Shiromani. His one is Bhakti Charu Maharaj. And Charu means Sundar, beautiful. And Maharaj was actually beautiful, even physically speaking. He was beautiful. In his gestures, he was beautiful. In his looks, he was beautiful. In his smile, he was beautiful. If you look at his feet, they were literally lotus feet. One is that, you know, they don't look like lotus feet, but they are okay lotus. But his feet were so soft. Those who have done Abhishek, I have seen photographs of Maharaj's lotus feet. They are lotus because they contain makarand of Shuddha Bhakti. And that's why they are lotus feet. But in touch also, in look and feel also, they are literally lotus feet. So Maharaj, hands lotus, feet lotus, activities lotus, speaking lotus, singing like lotus, personality lotus, his temples are lotus, devotees are also lotus. Wow. So a personality like him, if you read his biography, Ocean of Mercy, it is very evident to any devotee that actually he's a personal associate of Srila Prabhupada. He's personal associate. Doing so much of glorious seva, so much of compassion. He was also going to have a spiritual Disney park in USA in Orlando. He took a big tract of land and there people can Americans would come, have spiritual rejuvenation, and in this way they will get connected to Krishna. So thinking to such an extent to bring all the souls to the family of Krishna, only a Paramahamsa devotee can think like that. A broad-hearted devotee whose heart is like a palace of love and compassion can think like that. And I see over here so many flourishing devotees and this flourishing community, ever-expanding community, that seems like one day these walls would break. So many devotees are coming to honor this festival, take mercy from such festival. That shows that Maharaj is inspiring all of us. Although we do miss Maharaj. We do miss Maharaj. But yet at the same time, I can see that Maharaj and his mercy has dispersed itself into all of our hearts. And that's why whenever I meet any disciple of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj, I see a more excelled version of a devotee. Usually after a guru, people sometimes become so sad that they may lose little enthusiasm. But here I see devotees are enthusiastic because Maharaj somewhere he has entered into the heart of devotees. In this way, devotees are enthusiastically serving, they are preaching. Although in their heart, there is virah, this feeling of separation. But yet at the same time, we can see that Maharaj's mercy is gracing all the hearts. When Srila Prabhupada, he was passing by the Samadhi, Pushpa Samadhi, not Pushpa Samadhi, Samadhi of Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Maharaj in Mayapur Dham. So somebody asked Srila Prabhupada, "Do you miss your Guru Maharaj?" He said, "No, I don't miss him. He's in my heart. So similarly for the disciples of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj, well, do you miss your Guru Maharaj? Many disciples say, "Well, we don't miss him. He's in our hearts." Yes, whether somebody would see him as Diksha Guru or Shiksha Guru, he inspired many, 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 many souls. So such a powerful soldier in Srila Prabhupada's army, such a compassionate preacher, a lover of Vaishnava songs, His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj will be remembered for next 10,000 years. That there was one era. There was one era which existed where devotees were so fortunate to see His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj. See him walking, see him talking, see him singing. That was an era. It would be remembered in coming years. So that's the glory of Maharaj. In fact, there are many, many more glories. But yes, the way Maharaj has touched everyone's heart is so unique and so sweet. So we seek blessings of Maharaj on this most auspicious occasion, that the way he has served, he has told the whole world, what does that mean to be an ideal disciple? Srila Prabhupada told us, what does that mean to be a spiritual master? But from where we learn that, what does that mean to be an ideal disciple? From the very character, from the very exchanges, loving exchanges of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaji, we can learn, what does that mean to be an ideal disciple? He actually gave his life for his Divine Guru Srila Prabhupada. So we can learn from each and every gesture of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaji. So we pay millions and millions of obeisances at his most glorious lotus feet, that he may bless us with pure devotional service, because pure devotional service resides in the words of spiritual master, in his blessings. So we seek blessings of His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj Sri Gurudev Ki Jai. And of course, we have to glorify Srila Prabhupada as well, who gave us His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj. So Srila Prabhupada, has got various personality, various aspects in his personality. So I would like to highlight today the mystical nature of Srila Prabhupada. Usually he did not highlight the mystical nature of Srila Prabhupada. Why? Because he knew that if we highlight the mystical nature, the magical nature, the miracle nature, the miraculous nature, then seeing chamatkar ko namaskar, only less intelligent people can come. So he did not highlight, but he had mystical powers, Srila Prabhupada. Once he was in Kumbh Mela, and there was one tantric. He was very powerful tantric. And then he would tell everyone, chant everyone, hey Kapali, hey Kapali. And people around were chanting, hey Kapali, hey Kapali. So two Srila Prabhupada's disciples were also there. And knowing that, oh, this guy is just a show businessman. So this tantric also told these disciples of Srila Prabhupada. He said, hey, you also chant, hey Kapali. So devotee said, yeah, hey Kapali, hey Kapali. So they teased him. So this guy had some mystical powers. He said, oh, you're teasing me. And then he had some mantra siddhi. And then he said, hey Kapali. And then one of the disciple became paralytic and he fell to the ground. So another disciple, he ran away. He met Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada, there is one tantric in Kumbh Mela. He said, hey Kapali, and that disciple of yours now, he's crippled. He's paralyzed. He's there on the ground. Srila Prabhupada said, bring that tantric to me. And that tantric was called. And then Srila Prabhupada was sitting on his rocking chair. He said, so you are that hey Kapali tantric? He said, yes Maharajji. He said, so you made my disciple crippled with your mystical power. He said, yes Maharajji, he was teasing me. That's why he got punished. Okay. And then Srila Prabhupada had some flowers next to him. And then he threw those flowers on that tantric. And as he threw that flower on that tantric became crippled and he fell to the floor. And then devotees were astonished. Are bhai, Prabhupada ji ne kya kar diya? Tantric kaisi taisi kar di? And then Srila Prabhupada, with a lot of gravity, he said, how dare he touch my disciple? I love my disciples more than my life. How dare he? But devotees are also anxious. And here is one disciple. Here is tantric also lying crippled. Srila Prabhupada said he would be fine in a few hours. But first my disciple should be fine. And then Srila Prabhupada also revived that devotee. He took those flowers, same flowers. He said, just sprinkle these flowers on that disciple of mine. He would be fine. And then later on, when that disciple came back, so he gave some of the flowers to that disciple and said, now sprinkle some of these flowers on this tantric. And then he also threw those flowers on that same tantric. Same flowers which called crippling of the body. Same flowers remove all that crippling thing. So that phase we see that Srila Prabhupada had mystical powers. Once Srila Prabhupada, he decided to have a temple in a place. But the land experts said, well, the land is like a clay. So in case you make a heavy structure, it will sink into the land. Why? Because the land is not very solid. Srila Prabhupada said, no, we will have a temple here. Devotee said, Srila Prabhupada, the land experts have told that this land is more clay in nature. The temple will sink into the land. Srila Prabhupada said, but we will make a temple here. But how? And then Srila Prabhupada took his cane and then he marked one rectangular figure, 1 acre or so. And then he said, now dig. Devotee said, Srila Prabhupada, we have already taken care of the land. We have already checked. This land is very clay in nature, so that's why we cannot. Srila Prabhupada said, dig. And then that land was dug at that time. Only in that rectangular place, there was one solid stone slab. The rest, everything was clay. So with his cane, he can create a stone slab. Somebody asked him, how do you choose a land for making your temple? You made 108 temples. How do you decide the land? He said, all these places where our temples are to come, Brahmaji, who is our parampara HOD, he has done Bhumi Pujan. And I know where all those places are where he has done Bhumi Pujan. He said, but how come you know? He said, I was there with him. So he had mystical powers. One very powerful tantric, he came to meet Srila Prabhupada in Kumbh Mela. And then he said, Swamiji, we know that you are very famous, Hare Krishna, founder Acharya. Show me some magic. Srila Prabhupada said, well, what magic do I know? you show me some magic. He said, okay. So he took some clay, he took some sand particles from the pot. And then he said, okay, Swamiji, so this is sand, right? Okay, now I'm closing it. Jai Kali Kalkatte wali tere bachon ne jai Kali. Said, now bring your hand. And then Shri Prabhupada placed his hand and then he placed that sand. And that sand got converted into sugar. He said, oh, you converted sand into sugar? Said, Swamiji, kaisa laga? Shri Prabhupada said, well, I am diabetic, so I can't do anything of this. So, can you convert this back into sand? He said, yeah, I can do that. Jai Kali Kalkatte wali tera bachana jai Kali poo. Sand. Shri Prabhupada said, wow, you are so impressive. Can you do it again? Said, Swamiji, for you, one more time. Again, he took sand. He said, jai Kali Kalkatte wali tera bachana jai Kali poo. And then he placed that thing in the hand of Shri Prabhupada. It was still a sand. So Shri Prabhupada said, well, this time it is not converted into sugar. He said, Swamiji, well, it should have. Let me do it again. Jai Kali Kalkatte wali tere vachana jai Kali poo 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 poo. Again, sand. And then Shri Prabhupada said, well, anyways, you can place the sand back in the pot. And then Shri Prabhupada gave it in the hand of that tantric. And then when he opened, it was sugar. And this tantric ran away. He said, Swamiji has taken my power. Swamiji has taken my powers. And once in Kirtan, one devotee came and he gave dab to Shri Prabhupada. Coconut water. And then Shri Prabhupada drank. And then he gave to the secretary. And then he drank. And then he gave to other devotees. And there were around 50 to 100 devotees here. And they all drank from that single dab. This is very mystical. How is it possible? Ek dab to ek aadmi nipta deta hai. 50-100 log kaise? So once it was tasted by Shri Prabhupada and he gave it. That was like Akshay Patra. The spiritual one. Distributed. Wow. So these are some of the mystical pastimes that Shri Prabhupada exhibited. So he had those powers. But he never exhibited in public or highlighted them because he wanted philosophy should be highlighted. Seeing philosophy, intelligent class of people come. Seeing miracles, less intelligent class of people come. So he wanted intelligent class of people to come. So he did not highlight this aspect of his personality. But he had mystical powers as well. Of course, he is Srila Prabhupada. So we pay millions of obeisances to him. In fact, there was one astrologer. He saw a photograph of Srila Prabhupada. He said, this man will make a house whose shelter would be taken by the all four sampradayas in future. And you see, actually, so many temples of different sampradayas also, they are coming to ISKCON that we can't manage. ISKCON knows how to manage temples. So please take our temple. Hare Krishna. Shri Prabhupada ki jai. Okay, oh, so many Vaishnavas are waiting here. So here we'll have now Guru Puja, Pushpanji, etc. Haribol! His Holiness Bhakti Charu Swami Maharaj Ji ki jai. His Holiness Bhakti Charu Maharaj 78th Vyas Puja Maha 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 Mahotsava ki jai. Our beloved founder Acharya Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Nitai Nitai Gaur Premanande.